Hey guys, and welcome back to another Unreal Engine 5 tutorial. So in today's video, it's going to be another nice, quick and simple one where we're just going to be creating a basic fisheye lens post-process material for our games. So I'm going to be doing this onto our Bodycam system, which I made in the last video, but without further ado, let's just get right into it. So the first thing we're going to want to do is hit Control Space to open our content browser, go to the folder you want, right click, create a material, and I'm just going to name this PP for post-process underscore fisheye, and then we'll open it up straight away. In here, the first thing we want to do is on the left, we want to go into material domain, and change it from surface to post-process. This will now leave us only with the emissive color, but it means it will work as a post-process material, which is perfect for what we want. Let's start from left to right, so let's go all the way over to the left into some empty space, and right click and get a screen position node like this. We have our input data, screen position. Out of the viewport UV, what we want to do is get a mask node. So we're going to go under here, component mask, and we want to make sure only R and G, so red and green, are ticked. Out of this, we're going to go into an addition node, so just a simple add, with that going into A, and we want to have B just be a simple value. So if we hold down one and left click, we can get a constant like so, and we're going to set the value to be minus 0.5, and we'll connect that up into B like so. So we're now adding these two together. Let's select this and hit C to comment it, and we're going to name this one screen position center, as that is what this is doing. It is getting the center of the screen, as that is obviously where we want the fisheye lens to kind of be working from. Out of the result of the add, what we're going to do is we're going to go into a radial gradient exponential, like so, with that going into the UVs. We then want to hold down one left click again to get another constant value, leaving this as a value of 0, connecting it into center position V2. Then the radius and density, we want to have these as scalar parameters. So let's hold down S and left click to get a scalar parameter like so. And I'm going to name this one area radius, the default value being 1, connecting that into the radius. And then we'll hold down S, left click again, naming this one area falloff. And this is going to be the density. I'll give this one a default value of 1 as well. And let's apply that. So now we also have our radial gradient exponential. We're not quite done with this yet. What we want to do is out of the radiant gradient exponential output node, we want to get a 1 minus x, so just 1 minus, like so. And then this is going to go into something else. We want to right click and search for switch parameter. And we're going to name this one simply invert. True is going to come out of the 1 minus, and false will just be the radial gradient exponential, like so. So essentially, this is obviously going to be the radial, as obviously you know what a fisheye lens, it comes from the center of the screen, and it then has a radial fall off. So we can again select that and hit C to comment it, so we have this here. And I'm going to move these over to the left a little bit more once again. Out of the invert, we want to go into a multiply. So let's hold down M, left click. B is going to go into invert there. A is going to go into the addition there. So we're multiplying the screen center position by the radial fall off. This is going to go into another multiply. So hold on M, left click again, with that going into B. And A is going to be another scalar parameter. So hold on S, left click. And this is going to be the intensity. And I'll give this a default value of 0.5. Connecting that into A of the multiply like so. Then we're very nearly done. What we want to do now is get a subtract node. So we'll just simply search for it there. B is going to be the multiply. So we're subtracting this multiplication here from something else. And that something else wants to be this mask here. So screen position going into the mask, that will be into A there. So let me connect that up. And then I'll double click this to get some root nodes just to keep it looking nice and organized. And then very simply, one last thing here. Out of subtract, we want to get a scene texture. And we're going to set the scene texture ID to be post-process input 0. Just so this now knows it is definitely a post-process, and the color will go into emissive color there. And now we should have our fisheye lens all set up and working perfectly for us. So if we were to apply and save this, we should be able to test this out. What I'm also going to do is in our content browser, I'm going to right click and create a material instance. And if we open this up, we can now see we can tick all of these and change all the values about if we wanted, so you can invert which way the post process goes like that. If you wanted to, you can increase the intensity, the radius, the fall off. You can see what it's doing. Obviously, this is a very extreme example, but I'm just showing you it working. So you can change all of those nice and easily with this material instance here. So let's save that, and then we'll close it. And what we need to do now is make sure we have a post-process area in our map. So you should have one by default. If we search for post-process, you have a post-process volume. But if you don't have one, go up to this quickly add up here and search for post-process and just add in a post-process volume there. Once you've got it selected, what you probably want to do is tick infinite extent or unbound like so, just so it affects the whole map, not just inside of the volume. Then we're going to search for materials. We're going to open up post-process materials, add an array element, and we're going to choose an asset reference. With this is going to be our pp underscore fisheye, and we want the instance like so. And now you can see we have this basic fisheye lens effect here, working perfectly for us already. And if I had to make this a little bit smaller here so we can access this, what I can do is I can also change all these values and you can see what difference it's making. So invert is obviously like that, not quite how we want it. The intensity, the radius, the fall off, all of this stuff we can change. For me, I think default is going to be perfectly fine, but obviously again, you can change it for your own custom needs. So if I hit play, we can now see we have this body cam system with this fisheye lens here. So this just looks a lot better and a lot more realistic as to what you would expect to see on a body cam. And again, you can customize it to have it looking completely different for you as well. But I think that'll be it for this video, as we've done everything we want to do. What we've done is we set up a fisheye lens on a post-processed material so that we have this on our body cam, for example, where it's looking nice and realistic like this. And this obviously can work in anything you want. It doesn't just have to be for a body cam like this, but this is the best example I've found. So thanks so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it and I hope you found it helpful. And if you did, please do make sure to like and subscribe down below. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.